Hi, my name is Dr. Gabriel Neal. I'm a board-certified family physician with the Texas A&M College of Medicine. Currently, we have patients in our community with COVID-19 infections, and I am part of a team of doctors that are caring for them. A common question that we receive is, if I get symptoms of COVID-19, such as a fever or a cough or shortness of breath, what should I do? And the answer is call your doctor first. Doctors all over our country and in different communities are handling patients with symptoms differently depending on the resources of that community. So the first step for every patient is call your doctor. Don't just go to the clinic, don't just show up to the emergency room, but call your doctor first and explain that you're having some of those symptoms, and then follow the advice of your doctor. Fever, cough, and shortness of breath are the most common symptoms, but you don't need all three to be considered someone who might have COVID-19. Just having a fever, just having a cough, just having shortness of breath in and of themselves can be the first symptom of the infection. For a lot of patients, COVID-19 will be a mild illness. And so just staying at home and isolating themselves from the community is the treatment, and recovering at home from that. And so after they talk to their doctor, it may just be that they need to stay home, and that is probably going to be the case for most people. But depending on their situation and the severity of their symptoms, their doctor may choose to tell them to come in and be evaluated in a clinic somewhere, or at a different clinic that they might than what they're used to even, or sending them directly to the emergency room for prompt evaluation. If you are someone who has COVID-19 or has been exposed to COVID-19 and is on a 14-day self-quarantine at home, everyone that you live with should also follow that quarantine. We know that people need to go out and take care of themselves. They need to get food, they need to get essentials of daily living. And so for people who have symptoms of COVID or have been exposed and are at home and on quarantine, we're really encouraging having them have friends or family who do not live with them to go and retrieve the medications they need or the food that they need and deliver them to the house so that folks with symptoms or could be shedding the virus will not be out in the community spreading the disease. A common question is, what does it mean to social distance? Well, mainly this means keeping a safe distance from other people to keep the spread of the virus from occurring. We know that the virus lives in the moisture or air droplets that come out of our mouth and our nose whenever we're breathing. And so the thought is that 6 feet is a safe enough distance to keep away from people to prevent them from breathing in those water droplets from the other person's breath. And so if you can't imagine 6 feet, think 2 arms length. So if I put out my arm and someone I'm talking to puts out their arm and we're 2 arms lengths away, that's probably far enough to keep from spreading the disease. If you do have COVID symptoms, the best treatment is rest, fluids, good nutrition, and then taking medicines that we might normally take for a cold or for the flu. Currently, there's not a specific prescription treatment for COVID-19, and so it's about managing symptoms at home, and cold and flu medicines are the current best treatment for that. Things that help us recover are namely rest, fluids, and good nutrition. It is really important that we rest. For our body's immune system, this is critical. When we don't get enough rest, our immune system doesn't work right, and we can't fight off infections efficiently. If we don't stay hydrated, our body can't work right. And it's very common for patients who get any kind of respiratory infection, including COVID-19, to become dehydrated. So aggressively drinking water is important for the recovery. COVID-19 seems to last between 2 and 6 weeks, depending on the severity and the state of health that the person has at the time of the infection. So it's kind of a long illness compared to other colds that might just last a few days. The most important thing we can all be doing, those of us that don't have symptoms of COVID-19, are to social distance so that we prevent the spread. The way that we're going to win the battle of this pandemic is to prevent the spread of the illness, and that's through social distancing and following the directives of your local health authorities and government. So follow the directive for shelter in place, follow the social distancing advice or request, and we can win. If we don't do that, then this virus is going to continue to spread, and it's going to result in the death of a lot of people. One common situation is when people are at home and living with someone who has symptoms, but they don't have symptoms themselves. What can they do to protect themselves from getting it? Well, distancing themselves from their family member who has an infection is very difficult, but they still should try as much as possible to stay outside of that 6-foot range while they're providing food and water and such for them while they recover. But washing your hands frequently while you're at home is a big way to prevent the transmission from one family member to another family member. So whether you're using hand sanitizer or washing your hands with soap and water for 20 seconds, between any kind of contact with a person who has symptoms is really, really critical. And then cleaning common surfaces that you would all particularly use, like the kitchen counter or bathroom counter. This is important steps for preventing transmission within a household. In this challenging time of this pandemic, COVID-19, I think it's really important to remember that great challenges offer us the opportunity to do great things. We are going to get through this. And I want to encourage everyone out there that as bad as it's going to get, and we don't know how bad it's going to be in the end, we are going to make it through. And I know that we are going to rise as a community, as a state, as a country to the challenge that COVID-19 is bringing us. And the best part of ourselves is going to show through. And so I just want to take this moment to say that's how I feel about it. And I'm encouraged by all the acts of kindness and generosity that I see in the hospitals and in our community. And I see the determination in people's eyes to do the right thing. And I know that because of that, we are going to make it through.